Are you looking for a company intranet? Talking about a place where you can post updates just to your company, maybe do a little team directory, and have some other assets where everyone on the team can find what they're looking for? Well, if so, you've come to the right place, because in this video, I'm going to show you how to build your own company intranet in just a few minutes using no code, specifically a template already established inside of Softr. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you to get organized and automated with these different no-code tools. Now today I'm going to be featuring one of my favorite no-code tools, Softr. Now Softr started as a front-end solution for no-code designers and builders, and so today we're going to be using Airtable as a back-end to create our data schema all from just a few clicks in our template. Now, as we move along here, I want to invite you to join me and follow along in your own screen. Wherever you found this video, I will be sure to share the link so that you can immediately start using this template, download the same database schema that I'm going to be using, and build the same front end. Again, you're going to rely on two tools to do this, Airtable for the back end and Softr for the front end. Now, let's go ahead and jump on into it. On my screen here, you can see the example template that I'm going to be using here. And as it mentions here, the different features and functionality of the template are being able to post about company news, having your employee directory, doing a little document management. I know this is important for our company. You know, our different team members are signing contracts and need to see all of their stuff in one place, so that's fantastic. Also having tools and perks, discussions, internal discussions for the team, employee recognitions, very important, and then also event management and RSVP. So a lot you can do with this template, and I also want to highlight that you can toggle these things on or off. You, as the owner of this space, when you create your own application, you can turn this on and off. You can remove some features. You can even add additional things. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's use this template. And I first have to select my data source. Now I don't yet have a data source built, so I'm going to add a new one here. Note that for other backend options, in other cases, I could use Google Sheets or Smart Suite, but this particular template is only currently available for Airtable as a backend. So I'll make that selection. We'll use Airtable. And on the next screen, it's going to open up in a new window and allow us to authorize this connection. So here we go. I can go ahead and just say, hey, let's add a certain level of permission. I'll say use the whole workspace, and we'll grant access for this. Now on the next screen, we are asked to copy the base into our Airtable account. And what this is doing, it's actually creating the back end, all of the different pieces that we are going to need in order to build this front end application, because the front end application is what we're building in Softr. But again, we're creating that data schema on the back end. So we have to choose where we're going to be sharing this. And for me, I'll go ahead and drop it into this workspace called Enterprise Demo, and I'll go ahead and add the base. And now just that simply, we've created the entire data schema that Softr is going to tap into in order to build our front end. So here we have all the different components. And up here at the top, these different tabs or tables, each of them represents a specific set of data that we're going to refer to in the end application. So here's my employees, all the different employees who are on our team. I can close down this side panel and continue to explore. Here are the different teams. And of course, we've linked teams to employees. So the employees essentially belong to a specific team: sales, marketing, engineering, or operations. We have news here. This is where we can post about different pieces of information of the company. We have our events, event registrations. We have feedback, where people can put out new information and, you know, request different changes to be made into the company. We have resources. We have files, recognitions, posts, and lastly, comments. So a lot of different components here, but I want to highlight the fact I didn't have to build any of this. It automatically came in through the creation of the template. Now we flip back into Softr, and here it's saying, all right, we got your app. It's all ready to go. Let's get this thing set up. So just like this, we are now building the application inside of Softr. This is the front end component. And so here we are. If we were to watch this load that quickly, we can go over to pages on the left-hand side, and these are all the different pages that have automatically come in with the creation of this template. So we've got all the different components that we already mentioned. The homepage, news, details on the news, events, employee directory, we've got our teams, etc. So in order to really understand how all of this works, let's just pick a page. Let's go to news, for example. Here on my news page, you're gonna see the page loading, and we see on like a timeline view here all the different components. And all of this is brought in by what's called a block. We can click this block, and on the right-hand side of our screen, it opens up the different elements of the block. And so here is where we chose the source for this. And automatically, it knows that the source for this particular application is that very database that we just created over into Airtable. It was called Company Intranet by Softr. And of course, it's referring to a specific table in that data set, and it's bringing that information in to our application right here. So this is the source. Moving over to the next piece, we have our content, and this is where we're choosing what is showing up on this timeline. So we're saying we want to bring in the published date, we want to bring in a news headline, we want to bring in a summary and an image. So these different components, these are the contextual or content pieces that we're bringing in on our application. Again, all of this data lives in the data source. Now we have actions. So if we need to, we can create buttons that allow people to do or take new actions inside of the data set. So here we have the button of adding a new story. So somebody can add a new piece of information or a new news to the overall system here. We also have styles. This is where we can kind of zhuzh up the application that we build. So we can choose things like fonts, background colors, padding, etc. And then lastly, we have visibility. Now, visibility is where we can set up certain rules to say, this can only be seen by members of a certain team or people with a certain access or only logged in users. We have all kinds of capabilities over our visibility inside of Softr, and this is controllable at the block level as I've shown here. All right, so moving on beyond this, let's on the left-hand side click into users and take a look. All of this data has already been synced up with the application back end that we have in Airtable. So all of the users that we find right here live in our employees table in Airtable. And we can add new users here, and they'll automatically show up as new users in our system. And of course, we can delete users from here as well by selecting them and taking the action to delete. Now, for us, I want to impersonate somebody and actually log in and understand what it looks like when they access this system. So first, in order to do this, we're gonna have to publish our app. In the upper right-hand corner, I click on publish, and then one more time, confirm that I'm ready to publish the app, get a little confetti on the screen, and we're good to go. Now, my app is live. Just that simply, I already have this team intranet already living, and it's my own instance that I have full control and customization capabilities over. Now that it's published, I can now impersonate somebody on my team. So let's first understand who I'm going to impersonate here. So I'm going to flip back into Airtable. I'm going to take a look at my employees. So over here, I've got Ryan Garcia. He is the COO. He is on the operations team, and he is a manager. Now, all of these different components that live here in the employees table matter because we can dictate what kind of access Ryan or anyone has based on what team they're on, what role they have, etc. So we have to bear that in mind while we are accessing the application and impersonating Ryan. We are doing that with manager level permissions on the operations team. Let's go ahead and click back into Softr now and find Ryan again from the list. Here he is. And we can just impersonate him by copying out his magic link. Magic links allow us to then access this application if we paste them in a new browser window and impersonate that very person. It's also the fast way that the actual person can log into the application. They can simply access their magic link, bookmark that, and then every time they log in from their browser, they're gonna have their unique instance. So here we are logged in as Ryan, and we see that it's saying, welcome back, Ryan. And up here, we can actually see Ryan's profile. So we can go there, and this is gonna show us all the information from Ryan. So here is his photo. Again, he's a manager, title of COO, etc., etc. Note that Ryan can actually edit this information. No one else can, but because this is his profile, he can edit it. So maybe there's a typo in his phone number that he notices. Click on edit, come on down to the phone number. Let's make that 2136 instead, and we click update. Now, the important thing to understand is that we're actually updating the data that lives back in Airtable as well. And then the updated information is reflected inside of our app. So let's now go back into Airtable and confirm that to ourselves. When we look to see Ryan here, his updated phone number now reflects the changes that we just made. So again, this is allowing us to control or override data and update it accordingly. And this is all done based on those permissions that I was already outlining. Only Ryan can update his information, and that's what we would expect. So here we go. We can look at the other components of this. We can go right to the dashboard. On the dashboard, we're going to see a couple of quick links. So we can go to events, go to resources, go to teams. Here is the latest news right here. So this fake company just got a new funding round. We can look at upcoming events, and here are discussions. All of this conveniently built in just a few clicks. We can drill into these different components as well. Let's look at employees, for example. Again, we can update our own information as Ryan, but maybe Ryan needs to find out some information about Ethan on the team. He can click on here, and it's going to open up that particular component for Ethan. But note that there is no capability here for Ryan to update Ethan's contact information. He can, on the other hand, give him a shout out. So all kinds of actions have already been enabled inside of this app. We can give a shout out to this person. You're awesome. And great work. And just like that, we logged in as Ryan, have added a shout out now to Ethan. Now, after a quick refresh so that we collect the appropriate data, we can see that that shout out was just added. Of course, it knows that I, as Ryan, am the person who submitted that, and it's now showing up under Ethan. So obviously, a lot of capability right out of the box. In addition to this, we can look at the different teams. If you recall, we know that Ryan is on the ops team. Of course, that's just one component. We can drill into all the different teams and actually see the hierarchy here. So we've got Lily, who is Ryan's manager, and we can see this little org chart where we can expand the different folks that are reporting to Lily. And similarly, we can drill into those departments, get that org chart as well. It's a pretty cool new block that Softr has added, the capability to see this information here inside of our app. Beyond that, we can click on the individual teams and, of course, drill into that specific team. So here I am inside of the sales team, and I'm able to get a breakdown of the different folks there. Now, as I mentioned, there's a lot going on in this app, not just an employee directory, but also the ability to look at news and events. So here I've drilled into the news. We have this post from December 2022. I can click in and see details about that news post. What is this post about? Talking about a moment of celebration with team members and awards, etc. So this is just giving us the ability to collaborate better as a team. And in honesty, as I'm walking through this, I'm thinking how badly I need to build it for my own business as well, so my team can stay better connected. So there's a lot to explore here. I'll let you go ahead and install this and kind of walk through the different components yourself. Explore things like the events, the capability to throw out events in your organization. Or maybe you have specific days like President's Day where you don't have work, or you'll have an early day or an early day in the office. We can also go to discussions here on the left-hand side. Over on discussions, we can take a look at different things that people have asked. I know inside of our organization, we often use Slack for this, and it's hard to find an old thread over time. The nice thing about doing something like this in Softr is that once you create that post, you can actually go back to it. You can find that again through different tags or through the search bar, and it's not gonna just disappear like it does in our free Slack plan. In addition, you've got recognitions, resources, files, and ultimately feedback. So many different things here to allow your team to collaborate better and for everybody to feel like they really belong to something bigger than themselves. Hey, I know we went pretty fast in this video. Of course, if you have questions or comments, I would love to hear from you. Go ahead and drop them below. If there are specific things you want to learn how to do inside of Softr, let me know that as well. And in the meantime, keep on building.